morning and welcome to Village of Romeoville's workshop meeting this Wednesday, March 2nd, 2016 at 6 p.m. Can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Palmer.
Here.
Trustee Chavez.
Here.
Trustee Clancy.
Here.
Trustee Richards.
Here.
Trustee McClevitz.
Here.
Trustee Griffin.
Here.
Mayor Noak.
Here.
We have a quorum.
Clerk Holloway, will you lead us in the pledge?
Pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Very good. Therefore, first thing we have on tonight's agenda is Resolution 162062, a resolution authorizing the Village of Romeoville to accept the service proposal from Sikich LLP for professional audit services for the audit fiscal years ending in 2016, 17, and 18. Mr. Okwuchowski, please.
Good evening, Mayor and Board. Our contract with our Sikich expired at the end of the last audit. What I'm requesting is that we renew the contract for 3 years. Sikich has agreed to hold the price the same for this year versus last year, and then with 3% increases for the next 2 years. The village will be has three major GASB standards to implement over that time: GASB 68 for pension reporting, and GASB standard 74 and 75, which pertain to retiree insurance, which is kind of the pension equivalent for reporting those types of liabilities. So I would like to, through that time, stick with Sikich, and then after this contract, we would definitely go back out to bid for auditing services.
Very good. At the end of that period, but they've done a great job, and especially with rolling out those GASB things over the next few years. Great organization. Sikich has done an excellent job, so I think that works out pretty well. Any questions or comments? Very good. We'll move on.
Thank you.
Resolution 162063, resolution authorizing a development agreement for Veterans Parkway, Bolingbrook, LLC. Mr. Vogel, please.
Thanks, Your Honor. This is an agreement with the people that are developing the property at 990 Veterans Parkway. It's in Bolingbrook, but pursuant to some older agreements, that's an area that receives utility service from the Village of Romeoville. As we've done with a couple of other properties in this area in the past couple of years, we've entered into a development agreement that provides for a contribution to the village in the amount of $35,000 to help defray some improvements that are necessary to provide water sewer service to this area outside of the village, as well as to strengthen water service in parts of the northern area of the village.
Very good. We've got some of those properties we service. Happy to try and get it work out for all parties. So. Any questions or comments?
Mayor, this is consistent with the other two projects. The same fee is about, it's about the same fee we do with the other two projects.
Trustee McCuffins, please.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. As I was reading this, and obviously we've done it before, but the thought that came to mind is, what if it costs more or less than the $35,000 flat fee? Does it make sense to do a percentage of the product, or why would it not make sense to do a percentage of the project?
The fee has basically been calculated, I'm not going to say that it was calculated with mathematical precision or anything like that, but in terms of making a clean agreement where we say this is a fair and equitable share of what we anticipate the cost to be, we're not at the point of constructing it yet, so we don't really know what those costs are going to be until the, probably closer to the point in time when the work is actually being contracted for and being done. But it's in an interest of, let's get something worked out that we think is fair, that they're willing to go along with, get it over and done with, and move on, as opposed to, we could probably do something that would calculate it a little more precisely, or, a portion of percentage, but I think administratively the number of these agreements that we're going to be able to enter into might not be enough to justify some of the administrative work that would have to be done to get to that kind of a result.
So if we did, if you have to pay 40% of the final cost of this, when all is said and done, it might be more time and trouble to figure all that out than just to go ahead and do this up front, is that?
Trustee McClevitz, because there are so many different moving parts to this, And, you know, it's on the Bolingbrook side, and what's tributary to this, and this is all about, and John Jabrocki can kind of talk about it, the redundancy. This is more of a looping. John, can you talk a little bit about why we're doing this and how we came about, you know, because there's no precision here, how we came about this?
Sure. I mean, with respect to that, to the water main in particular, I mean, it's something that it's a redundant system into the Windham Lakes. We've got one feed under I-55. You guys are familiar. It's just at the north end of Bolt Park, right at that road where Crossroads is. So we've got, and historically, we've always had that one feed under there for redundant water systems, both with respect if we had an issue there, and with respect to storage fire flows. You kind of always want to have, Steve has called it, you know, belt and suspenders approach to things. That's where this secondary line has always come from. We were able to secure the easements, like was mentioned earlier, from both the parcels that are there. So this is just kind of the one of the last pieces of that puzzle.
So all in all, we're confident that the $35,000 is going to cover enough of our costs that we're not spending more money than we should on the project. Is that?
No, we will spend more than that.
Right.
I'm not sure that the cost is a couple hundred thousand, John.
Yeah, the cost is in excess clearly of this. You know, mm-hmm. as he mentioned earlier, there are two other developers that we've been able. Mm-hmm. This is the third in that area. Ideally, what we did was try to attribute it, you know, their percentage of a cost.
Sure.
Ultimately, this improvement, you can't just say is those three parcels. You know, this improvement really does provide a benefit for multiple parcels within that part of the community.
Mm-hmm.
So it wouldn't be fair to say, okay, let's just take it, divide it by three.
Okay.
So we did the best that we could to allocate a portion of it to the people who were front and center.
But ultimately, the users on that part of the system ultimately pay into the pot of that's coming from, that's paying for
without
the overall
a doubt, yeah.
improvement.
And it was obviously, we can't go back to people
right.
that have already built
right.
and
right.
say, oh, geez, we want $35,000. Mm-hmm. So what we've done is anybody building new to this mm-hmm. system 15 years ago when that was
sure.
done, there was really no formula put in place for any type of redundant system, nor did we know how much water would be used at that time
right.
as well, or the growth mm-hmm. that would take place. And so it became an issue about two, three years ago, we felt that, hey, this is something that's really needed.
Mm-hmm.
And so we started addressing it as new people came
gotcha.
In, new businesses came in.
Okay.
So and that's why there's not a per se formula.
Right.
Because there's several other businesses that are already en route.
Right.
You know, that we can't go after.
That makes sense. Thank you.
Very good.
Good question.
Any other questions or comments? Excellent. We'll move on. Resolution 162064, resolution authorizing the execution of a certain real estate contract for 10 Montrose Drive with the Northern Will County Special Recreation Association. Mr. Rich Vogel, please.
Thanks, Your Honor. As you'd indicated, this is to approve a real estate contract to sell the old police station building to the Northern Will County SRA, which most of you are probably familiar with over the years as the Tri-County SRA. The contract provides for a price of $725,000. SRA has been occupying the space for about the last 5.5 years or thereabouts, and had made the decision that acquiring it would be a fit for it, and the village, you know, had determined, of course, that it didn't have a further need for the property. They're going to have a 90-day due diligence period during which they're going to make all the investigations as to title, survey, and other matters that they think are relevant to their decision to close on the purchase. We have two other existing tenants in the space. One is the Historical Society. Assuming the closing of the property is completed, they're going to have a period of 6 months to stay on as a tenant, pending the finding new quarters. The Chamber of Commerce is also an existing tenant, and they're going to have a period of, five years after the closing, during which, you know, presumably they're going to be looking towards efforts to relocate and find new space as well.
Very good. Something we've been talking about and in the works for some time. It's a great partnership, great opportunity to allow that to still stay as a public use building. Anybody who's familiar with the organization knows how important it is to the region. We are a member of it, of the organization, so it's a great cause. It's nice that building can be reutilized for that usage. And it gives them a permanent home, which is very important. And you know, these types of activities are essential to our community, so and to the surrounding area. So I think it's a great partnership and a great cause, and I'm glad they'll be able to finally have a place to sit, really truly call their own home. So, questions or comments? Anyone else? Tristan McClevitz, please.
I just wanted to make one comment that part of my other job responsibilities, I do sit on the board there, so I will be, when it comes time to vote, I will be abstaining from the vote. So if there was a question why I'm abstaining, that's the reason why.
Very good.
Thank you.
Excellent. Then I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second.
Moved by Trustee Griffin, second by Trustee Clancy. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Trustee Clancy.
Aye.
Trustee Palmeyer.
Aye.
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Trustee McClevitz.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Very good. We'll go right into the regular board meeting of the Village of Romeoville this Wednesday, March 2nd, 2016 at 6:12 p.m. Can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Palmeyer.
Here.
Trustee Chavez.
Here.
Trustee Clancy.
Here.
Trustee Richards.
Here.
Trustee McClevitz.
Here.
Trustee Griffin.
Here.
And Mayor Noak.
Here.
We have a quorum.
Clerk Holloway, will you please lead us in the pledge?
To the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Very good. Petitions from the public? No petitions from the public. Consent agenda? Do I have a motion?
So moved.
Motion by Trustee Griffin, second by Trustee Richards. Any further discussion on consent agenda? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Trustee Palmeyer.
Aye.
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee Clancy.
Aye.
Trustee McClevitz.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Very good. Within that consent agenda, we have the minutes 160616, approval minutes February 17th, 2016 workshop meeting. Minutes 160617, approval minutes February 17th, 2016 regular meeting. 162171, approval of bill schedule A. 162172, approval of bill schedule B. 162173, approval of bill schedule C. 162174, approval of bill schedule D. Resolution 162065, resolution establishing a development security for the public improvements, water and sewer only, associated with 990 Veterans Parkway. Resolution 162066, resolution establishing development security for the public stormwater and erosion control improvements for Blaine Farm and Fleet. And resolution 162067, resolution reducing the development security for Duke Realty Development. Do I have a motion?
Motion to approve.
Second.
Second.
Motion to approve by Trustee Palmeyer, second by Trustee Clancy. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Palmeyer.
Aye.
Trustee Clancy.
Aye.
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Trustee McClevitz.
Aye.
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
We have a quorum.
Very good. Mayor's report. First, we'll start with Ordinance 161262, Ordinance amending Chapter 112.33, Classes, Licenses, the Village Code of Ordinances.
So moved.
Motion by Trustee Griffin.
Second.
Second by Trustee Richards. And again, for reference, that's for the Beer and Bacon Festival. So, which they've added more restaurants and venue and beer, so they'll be making more announcements. So go check out the website. And actually, interestingly enough, today, one of the ones they added was from our neighbors on Lamont, who I saw today, in Pollyanna, which is nice. Nice to get all the local restaurants and people to it. So, if without any further discussion, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Trustee Palmeyer.
Aye.
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee Clancy.
Aye.
And Trustee McClevitz.
Aye.
Motion carried.
As I was saying, I was able to attend Lamont State of the Village today. I want to commend my colleague Mayor Brian Reeves on an excellent presentation. They are a great partner to work with, and I want to thank him once again publicly too. We made an announcement recently with Metra and Congressman Lipinski about the addition of additional service on the Heritage Corridor line on Metra. And if not for the efforts of Congressman Lipinski and Mayor Reeves, who sits on the Metra board, we wouldn't be at that point today. It was a great partnership. All the communities worked together, Lockport, Romeoville, and Joliet. We all worked together to try and get additional service, and they will continue to look at improvements on the line, as he mentioned again today. But it's been a great partnership with everybody to finally see that moving forward. So I want to thank him and congratulate him again today on a great presentation. Just quick condolences to Sadiq and Kevin. It was hard, again, as we talk about, and unfortunately it seems way too often, the passing of special people and people that lives. And Kevin and Sadiq both lost loved ones recently, and two great guys that help me out in my state of village every year and do a lot in this community, and I really depend on. So I just want to let them know how much we're thinking of them. I want to thank the Romeoville High School for allowing me to come over and talk to the government students last week. Also, we had the groundbreaking for the Renwick Place with William Ryan Holmes. That was a great occasion. Kyle Searcy's Eagle Scout celebration was past Saturday. It was a great event. And I think we'll be inviting him over with his family here shortly to have a presentation here before, so everybody can, the village board can congratulate him as well, because it's a special occasion. So, and Beautification Commission was able to recognize Jackie Schneider on her service this past Monday. Very special person, and we really appreciate everything she's ever done. So, and also want to congratulate the Northern Will County Special Recreation Association team, who beat the village officials last night. I was unable to attend, but I heard it was a really close game. And but always a wonderful occasion for everybody, and we're happy to get everybody some pizza afterwards. I'll be moving on to the clerk's report, please.
Thank you, Mayor Noak. To start, the Community Service Council meets on March 15th at 6:30 p.m. at the CSC office in Bolingbrook. Like to congratulate Kirk and his staff on winning the award for excellence in financial reporting by the Government Financial Officers Association for the second year in a row. And a reminder to Romeoville voters that early voting at Village Hall is February 29th through March 14th from March 11th, sorry about that, from 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. for Romeoville residents only. And that's it for me.
Very good. Citizens Committees Commission Liaison Reports.
I got none.
Okay. Trustee Chavez says he's got nothing. We can fly through these real quick. Trustee Chavez is good. Trustee Palmiter, Finance Humane Society Special Event.
The only thing I have is our next finance meeting will be next Wednesday at 4 p.m. right here at Village Hall.
Very good. Trustee Griffin, Veterans EDC.
EDC had a recent planning session that the village manager coordinated, and it was a really productive session, and everybody contributed a lot, and it was really a good productive thing. Free money, everybody, free money. The Veterans Commission is offering two scholarships this year. I have to tell you, it was really disappointing last year, the few numbers of participants we had for basically, if you have a son, a grandson, a niece, a nephew who wants to attend college, who is either the child of a veteran or participates in ROTC, go onto the village website. The information is right there. It's a short submission form, and it's two really significant financial money cash scholarships form. So I encourage everybody to participate in that. And that's all I've got.
Very good. Great program. Trustee Clancy, Beautification Park and Rec.
Yes. First of all, I'd just like to thank Jackie for the tremendous job she did on the beautification. She had her little retirement party, and it went off very well. And also, as far as the rec center, the 12th annual Springtide Craft Show will be held Saturday, March 12th, from 9 in the morning to 3 in the afternoon. So come out and shop. There'll be over 100 booths with all kinds of handcrafted goods, jewelry, croquet, and a lot of others. And also the annual Pizza with Peter Rabbit will be held Friday, March 18th, from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. Thank you.
Very good. Trustee Richards, Planning and Zoning Board of Appeals, Rima.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Planning and zoning, we'll have a meeting on Tuesday, March 8th, 7 p.m. right here in the boardroom. A couple items on that agenda. They will be approving the 2016 Village of Romeoville zoning map, and they also looking at rezoning and general development plan approval for Troutman and Dom's for the retail development at the northwest corner of Route 53 and Romeo Road. That project is moving forward. They will also be looking at a final development plan for Thornton's at the northwest corner of Route 53 and Romeo Road as part of that development. So nice to see some activity there. There will also be that night a Zoning Board of Appeals meeting held to hear a request for a setback variance for Allison Lift on Enterprise Drive.
Very good.
All I have.
Very exciting period. I just talked to our good friends over there. I talked to Eric Troutman today, so very exciting to see those sites moving forward. So hopefully more will come soon after that. So, but a lot of activity in Route 53. So good to see. Tristan McClivitz, Youth Outreach, Green Team in Uptown.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. The Green Team, in the event that people are unaware, the recycling center on Budler Road has been closed due to circumstances out of our control. You can go to the village website to find out where you will be able to dispose of electronics in the area. So there are various areas, I believe I heard Best Buy and some other areas that are taken. So go on the website and you can get more information about that. As far as the Youth Outreach Commission, the next meeting is coming up Monday, March 7th at 10 o'clock at the Recreation Center. And just as was said earlier, as far as money, the Youth Outreach Commission also has a scholarship program. And again, there wasn't a whole bunch of people applying for it. So hard to understand because college costs are so expensive and everybody is saying that they're looking for money to help defray those costs. And here's some great opportunities to do that. So if you're interested to find out more information, you can go to Romeoville High School Counselor's Office. They have the information. You can contact the Recreation Department and find out how you can get the scholarship for the Youth Outreach Commission. And those applications must be turned in by Friday, April 1st. So you have a little bit less than a month to get that information. And one of the ways that the Youth Outreach Commission funds the scholarship, one of the fundraisers, is a pancake breakfast that's going to be coming up at the Springtide Craft Show that was talked about earlier. So that's March 12th. Get there early so that you can partake in the pancake breakfast and help fund the scholarship program. And then the last would be the Uptown Square Commission. And actually last night we did have a meeting and it was an excellent presentation by Fat Ricky's and Fran Coney's. The members of the Uptown Square Committee Commission had a lot of questions. I believe everybody walked away feeling that their questions were all addressed. Everybody's excited. This is going to be a very unique store and restaurant concept that I think will really be beneficial to the residents of the village. That's all I have.
Very good. Village Manager's Report.
I want to thank Trustee Chavez for coaching the team. I did understand from Mr. Opinchowski that Mr. Chavez thought he was coaching football. Yeah, we told people to tackle the guy with the ball. It was kind of a, but other than that, I thought everybody said they did a good job. So.
I couldn't understand why he called a 3rd and 10 play.
That's all I have. Thank you.
Very good. New business. We'll have to take these individually. First, ordinance 161259, ordinance amending chapter 93, nuisances.
So moved.
Motion to approve by Trustee Richards.
Second.
Second by Trustee Griffin. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Trustee Pallmeyer.
Aye.
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee Clancy.
Aye.
Trustee McClevitz.
Aye.
Motion carries.
Very good. Next, we have ordinance 161260, ordinance of adopting chapter 156, residential rental property licensing and crime-free housing of the Village Code of Ordinances.
So moved.
Motion second. By Trustee Pallmeyer, second by Trustee Griffin. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Pallmeyer.
Aye.
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee Clancy.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Trustee McClevitz.
Aye.
Motion carries.
Good. In reference to these last two, I just want to take a quick moment, if I might, and I want to thank the Realtors Association from our area, Three Rivers, and their representatives for coming in and meeting with the staff and discussing some of the things that they wanted to see talk about during it. Much of their input was included into this final draft. And as I had a conversation with one of their board members today, and I know that they're with us today and listening, the offer is open, as we did with any of our programs, and as we do with any group that maybe have an interest in any new program. The invitation is open as the program moves forward. If there are things that we need to reevaluate, look at, we are always open for that input, and we appreciate that partnership. So I just want to acknowledge that and thank them for their input. So next we have resolution 162062, resolution authorizing the village of Romeoville to accept the service proposal from Sikich LLP for professional audit service for the audit of fiscal years ending in 2016, 17, and 18.
So moved.
Second.
Motion by trustee Palminer, second by trustee Griffin. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Palminer.
Aye.
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee Clancy.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
And trustee McClevitz.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Very good. Next we have resolution 162063, a resolution authorizing a development agreement for Veterans Parkway, Bolingbrook, LLC.
So moved.
Motion by trustee second. Griffin. Second by trustee Richards. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Trustee Palmer.
Aye.
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee Clancy.
Aye.
Trustee McClevitz.
Aye.
Motion carried.
There you go. We're gonna give trustee McClevitz an opportunity. Very good. Therefore, now in discussion, resolution 162064. A resolution authorizing execution of certain real estate contract, 10 Montrose Drive, Old Police Station, Northern, to the Northern Will County Special Recreation Association.
So moved.
Second. Motion trustee Palmiter, second by trustee Griffin. Any further discussion? Hearing none, could I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Palmiter.
Aye.
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee Clancy.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Very good. And we'll have trustee McClellan join us again. Very good. And with that, board comments, trustee Chavez, please.
Yes, thank you, Mayor. Just want to start off with kind of a little note here from VOR-TV. They're seeking new members and volunteers. If you guys are interested in doing video production, producing programs, directing programs, camera operations, editing film, and hands-on training, please consider signing up and volunteering to work with VOR-TV here in Romeoville. So please, if you have an interest.
If you've got a family member getting married or something, yeah. I mean, and you want to video events, this is a great training ground for folks
Great training, I agree.
I encourage anybody to go and do that.
Absolutely.
Any grandparents that want to film their grandkids and all that.
Yeah. I agree, trustee. Also, I want to give my hats off to RHS. They took two top spots in the robotics competition here at JJC. Each team was required to build a program robots designed to handle five challenges over the course of the day. Romeoville High School robotics team turned in a strong showing on February 19th at Joly Junior College robotics engineering competition, securing second and third place in the experts division. So I just want to give congratulations to those kids. There's quite a bit of them, so I don't want to list them all out. But I think that's a great thing that they offered at the high school. I wish they had that when I went to school there. But I think it's awesome, and they did really well. So I compliment all those kids, and obviously the teachers that are teaching them this software, this program. And one more thing, they're having our first ever mother and son night out, April 1st here at the rec center. I think this is going to be really good. I hope it's a big turnout, just like a father-daughter dance. But if you have a young child under 12, it's an amazing night with music, magic, reptile show, slime, and tasty food. What kid doesn't like slime, right? Don't miss out on the fun. Register by March 11th. The fee is $27 for residents, $41 for non-residents. April 1st, 6 to 9 p.m., our first mother and son night out. So please schedule if you can. That's all I have, Mayor.
Very good. I know that Jenny and many of our friends are talking about going. So, Trustee Pallmeyer, please.
Thank you, Mayor. First of all, I'd like to also offer my condolences to Kevin McHale and Sadiq. It's tough to lose a family member, and my condolences go to their families. Congratulations to Jackie Schneider for her many years of dedication, not only to our Beautification Commission, but throughout our village over the years. She's been active in so many things. I've worked beside her on many projects. Great lady, wife of our former clerk, Robert Schneider, whose name you'd see if you went over to Heritage Trail over by Isla Cache. She'll be missed, but she deserves some peace and quiet, I'm sure, for a change. Mm-hmm. And that's all I have. Thank you.
Very good. Trustee Griffin, please.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I also want to extend my condolences to Kevin McHale and to Sadiq on their loss. I also want to congratulate, does she mind being called Romeoville's First Lady, Jennifer Noak, on her work at the Center for Disabilities, which had their annual fundraiser this past Sunday and set all kinds of records, and it was a great event and a great turnout, and congratulations to Jennifer on that. I also remind everybody that the Romeoville High School, Enrichment Foundation dinner and fundraiser is March the 11th, and so please turn out and help support this organization that helps support your kids. And that's it.
Very good. Thank you very much. Trustee Clancy, please.
Thank you. And also, I'd like to offer my condolences to Kevin and Sadiq on their losses. It's never easy to go through that. And then, as far as the basketball game that a bunch of people made comments to earlier, yes, we made it a little closer, and I thought we were going to get them, but they got us in the end. So they put up a good competition. Even though I must say that we did borrow one of their hot shots from in the past, Danny Wallace. And he made a couple three good three-point shots there. So he helped keep us in the game. So thank you, Danny. All that practice in the street out in front of the house is good. And I just wanted to rehash that T-ball and softball registrations are open at the rec center. And like I said before, anytime we're talking baseball, that means spring is on its way. And there's a free throw tournament. For further information on that, you can also call the rec center. And then Jackie Schneider, like I said earlier, she did a tremendous job, and so did her family, in the way the village grew, and they were always involved in a lot of different things. So we want to thank her again. And it was a tremendous night we had the other night. Thank you.
Very good. Trustee Richards, please.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I as well want to offer condolences to Kevin McHale and Sadiq Jamal on their losses. As has been said many times, never easy to lose a loved one, so our thoughts and prayers are with them at this time. I'm also going to mention the Center for Disability Services, a very successful fundraiser, but what a lot of people probably don't realize is this is an organization, if you look and you see it's based out of Joliet, it's got a Joliet address, it's got a Joliet school, but in reality they help people all over the area.
Six counties.
Okay, thank you. I didn't realize it was that big. Many of our Romeoville residents are served by this group. So if there's ever an opportunity to help them in any way, shape, or form, realize that they may be providing services for your neighbor. Just because it's not a Romeoville-based business or not-for-profit group doesn't mean they're not serving our residents. This group does a lot for many people. What else do I have on here? Congratulations, SRA, of course. Very fun basketball game last night. They keep improving. We keep getting older. I don't know how it's going to work out in your future years. Jackie Schneider, can't say enough about her. Friend of the family for many years. Amazing group of people. Bob Schneider was a great man. Jackie definitely deserves to relax a little bit. She's devoted many years to helping many people in this village. So it's a big congratulations to her. Last but not least, coming up in a couple of weeks is the Knights of Columbus St. Patrick's Day dinner, held at St. Andrew's Church every year, in their church hall, I should say, every year. Tickets are $15, or a table of 10 is available as well. again, so people don't may not realize, Knights of Columbus just recently made a donation to Northern Will County SRA and also to all of the elementary schools in Valley View School District. So the money raised by this group stays here locally. It's all going to help, in this case, helping special needs children and adults in our own community. So if you can support this group in any way, shape, or form, it would be appreciated. You can contact Rick Skorsky at 815-651-4585 or go to St. Andrew's Church's website and find information about this. The event will be held Saturday, March 12th. And that's all I have.
Very good. Thank you. Tristan McClovitz, please.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I also want to send my sympathies to Sadiq and Kevin in the loss of their family members. And also, I'd like to congratulate and thank Jackie Schneider. It's been said already, so there's not much more I can add to that, but what a fantastic person, and just the many, many years of service that she's given to this community is very much appreciated. Great job to everybody who participated in the basketball game. We had many trustees that participated, and I'm probably a little bit sore today, but I don't think too much. I don't see anybody limping, so I think everybody had a fantastic time, and it's always a great event that's well supported by everyone. REMA is offering an emergency preparedness course, so if you want to be prepared for an emergency, be certain to register for the course. Contact Mike Luttrell to find out more information. You need to register like ASAP. They need a minimum of 8 people in order for this to go. And the program actually starts really soon, March 8th, which is next Tuesday. So make sure to contact Mike immediately so that it doesn't get canceled this first time around. And I just want to put in another plug for the Springtide Craft Show. It's one of two craft events that the Recreation Department holds. They're very successful. A lot of people come out. It's just a fantastic event. And again, there's a pancake breakfast prior to that, or at the beginning of that, around 9 o'clock. And those proceeds are going to help both Northern Will County SRA as well as the Youth Commission. So just another plug, March 12th for the craft show. And lastly, I also wanted to congratulate the Finance Department and Kirk for receiving their award for financial reporting. The certificate that they receive is a certificate of achievement, and it's the highest form of recognition in the area of government accounting and financial reporting, and its attainment represents a significant accomplishment by a government and its management. So not something easy to attain, a lot of work to do it, and it shows how fantastic our finance department is doing as far as counting every penny and making sure it's accounted for. So great job, appreciate that. That's all I have, thank you.
Very good. We'll take a motion to go into executive session.
So moved.
Motion by Trustee Griffin, second by Trustee Clancy. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Trustee Clancy.
Aye.
Trustee Pallmeyer.
Aye.
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Trustee McClevitz.
Aye.
Motion carried.
And we won't have an announcement.